Hi, I'm Kim, and we are going to talk more about freedom. Let us go back to the definition of freedom. Well, freedom is a social concept that recognizes the dignity of individuals and is defined here as negative liberty or the absence of coercive constraint. For the past videos, human freedom, the foundation of human acts, and three positions of freedom were already discussed. Today, we are going to talk about freedom, responsibility, and justice. First, let us talk about understanding freedom and responsibility. There are two definitions of responsibility. The first one is accountability. Accountability means that you are accountable for an action that is free, whose source is I. So what is this I? I acted on my own, I decided on my own, and I am free from external constraints. For example, a person is morally responsible for an injury if, first, the person caused the injury or failed to prevent it when he or she could have or should have prevented it. Second, the person did so despite of knowing what he or she was doing. And third, the person did so out of his own free will. The second definition of responsibility is responsibility. The responsibility means the ability to give an account, the ability to justify actions that are truly responsive to the objective demands of the situation and meets the demand of justice. It is the ability to respond rather than act, and to consciously and deliberately choose our responses with intention and care. There are four types of responsibility: role responsibility, causal responsibility, liability responsibility, and capacity responsibility. Role responsibility are the duties one has for doing various things which come with occupying a certain role in the society. Causal responsibility is what caused something to happen. Liability responsibility is who is liable for something that is happening. And capacity responsibility is the capacity of a person to be held liability responsible for their actions. Next, let us talk about freedom and justice. The relationship of these concepts can be discerned when the network of relationships with fellow human beings and the goods intended by freedom is given consideration. Justice is giving to the other what is due. If a human being is to keep his freedom, he must assess his real needs with respect to what is available around his world and the equally real needs of his fellow man. What is due to the other is all that he needs to preserve and enhance his dignity as a human being. Throughout the development of the social related thinking, we came to the conclusion that we have three ways of judging justice: distributive justice, commutative justice, and absolute justice. Distributive justice is also called social justice, environmental justice, and economic justice. These are the same words. It requires, by all means, someone to distribute certain things and to find a fair solution to benefit a community or group of people. For example, in a society, there simply may not be enough food, shelter, or healthcare to go around, depending on the wealth level of a society. The demands of distributive justice must therefore be scaled to the resources available to the society. which in turn helps the community living in the area. The rules of commutative justice are precise and accurate. They concern the situations where one individual acts against another. It is finding a fair solution to fix the situation between two parties. For example, if someone assaults you or steals from you, their action is a violation of commutative justice. The criminal and the victim are all identifiable to everyone. You are the victim who needs to be compensated, and he or she is the criminal who needs to be punished. Lastly, according to Albert Camus, a French philosopher, absolute justice is achieved by the suppression of all contradiction. Therefore, it destroys freedom. The key to absolute justice is to do what someone does to you and add depending on how they did to you. It is the dream of all noble people, but it is only a dream. The Socrates of Plato's dialogues determines that it is not possible to define justice, in its essence, as an absolute thing. Freedom conditions justice, and justice is a condition of freedom when we realize that our obligation to give lies only on what we can give within the limited matrix of possibilities.